स्टूडेंट्स, कैसे हैं आप सब लोग? वेलकम टू अनदर सेशन ऑफ थिंक हटके. माय नेम इज राहुल रोहिला. कैसे हैं सब लोग? हाउ आर यू गाइस? गुड इवनिंग टू एवरीवन. बहुत अच्छा लगा यू गाइस आर हियर. सो इन द लास्ट वीडियो, हमारा प्रीवियस वीडियो वाज अ लिटिल स्मॉलर. वी डिडंट रीड आउट ऑल द कमेंट्स आप लोगों ने जो वीडियोज पे डाले थे. सो लेट मी रीड आउट द कमेंट्स फर्स्ट एंड देन विल कंटिन्यू. This week we will be doing number theory questions, so I will be taking different concepts of number theory. Uske saath saath, you know, all the questions that have come in PRMO, RMO, so all the Olympiad questions we will be discussing in this week's video. So every day I'll be giving you 3-4 questions, and every next day I'll be telling you the solutions and we'll be discussing the answers. So please make sure that you're commenting your answers in the video by tomorrow's video, okay? So like today, after you watch this video, please solve the questions and let me know in the comments what are your answers, so that in the next video I can read out your comments and I can tell you if your answers are right or not, okay? So thank you so much for participating. Let me just first read out the comments that you guys have put. Yeah, so my video, which was on Friday, so I'll be reading out the comments of my Friday video first, because I couldn't do that in the Saturday video. So I'm getting huge responses from you guys. Thank you so much for being a part of this. I've been so happy making new content for you guys, and every week we'll be planning out something and we'll be following that according to the plan. So this week's plan is number theory. So we'll be dealing questions, we'll be discussing theory related to number theory. So please stay tuned if you want to study more about number theory for this week. Okay, so we'll start off with the comments that you guys have given. Balakrishna Brahmacharyam, he said, sir, for question number 2, answer has real roots for any value of a greater than or equal to -1/4. So Balakrishna, please make sure that you watch yesterday's video. I have discussed the solutions in that video, and you can refer your answer from there. Okay, yeah. So next is by Pranav Singla. He says, sir, please tell important topics in mathematics for class 11th for KVPY. Pranav Singla, if you want to study for KVPY, KVPY mein you need to study it portion wise. Like in mathematics, if you take up algebra, so look for all the content that is there in algebra in 11th class, that is your arithmetic progression, your principle of mathematical induction, your binomial theorem. So all the starting topics of class 11th as well as 9th and 10th class topics which are of algebra. So like this, continue doing these topics. So analyze the past 10 year papers of KVPY. If you will notice that most of the questions that have come are more on the IQ level rather than on the syllabus level. So just make sure that when you're giving your KVPY exam, you have already done all the past 10 year papers, and also you have done your class 11th mathematics acche se, the topics, the starting topics that is. And also you need to revise your 9th class and 10th class mathematics as well. Okay. Next question is by Suraj Sangan Bhatla. He says, sir, my sister is in class 6. Please give tips for PRMO. Is this correct point to start for PRMO? So Suraj, class 6th is the foundation age where she needs to develop the foundational skills for mathematics. So right now, if you want to aim for PRMO, what you should do is figure out all the topics that are going to come in 7th, 8th, 9th and 10th class. So pick it by certain topic wise, like algebra. So right now she's in 6th class, so she's going to learn the basics of algebra in 6th class. So if you have any vacations coming up or you have holidays, since you are her elder brother, you can help her out in understanding more about algebra, more about geometry, more about number theory by yourself, okay? So a little input has to be given from your side because she is at a very foundational age. So just help her out. I will, you can start off with the basic topics that come, and you can follow the book of pre-college mathematics. So this book is Challenges and Thrill in Peak College Mathematics. Obviously your sister can't read that book, it's a little high level. So what you can do is you can read it yourself and try to make her understand in a much simpler way. So I would recommend let her sixth class pass, whatever she's learning right now, make her foundational mathematics strong first, and then make her start preparing for you know, Olympiads from seventh class onwards. So prepare her for 1 year, tell her more about mathematics, give her a little fascination so that she has the enthusiasm herself to continue this. Okay? Yeah. So next question is, next person is Pinkin. Pinkin says, "Sir, my name is Shan Mukha. I'm using my brother's account. Say me hi, sir. I got 80 and 80 in my maths paper. Thank you, sir." That's great, Shan. That's amazing that you got 80 and 80 out of mathematics. Please continue doing the hard work, and whatever you do, do it with 100% passion. And that's great. Keep following the channel, Shan, and it'll be amazing when you develop skills which can help you in Olympiad exams. Okay. Chaliye. Next question is by next comment is by Indra Ballav Sonowal. She says, "Sir, love your class. Thank you for Vedantu for providing such a wonderful platform for mathematics lovers. Hope one day in India also the craziness of Olympiad will increase and we could achieve gold for our country." I also feel the same, that we'll soon achieve gold for our country. We have received gold individually, but we have not received gold as a team. So we are looking forward to the time when the whole team representing India will get gold in IMO and also shine the name of India. That'll be very amazing, something extraordinary. And thank you so much, Indra. Thank you so much. It gives me a immense hope, immense motivation that I can carry on doing this good work and helping you guys out in solving day-to-day questions that come in Olympiad. Okay? And also making math easy. Madhav says, "Sir, third question easily ho gaya. I have sent you the solution quadratic ke basic par." Ha Madhav, I checked your solution and it is correct. Very nice. Naresh Banwala says, "Sir, I am Smile, daughter of Naresh Banwala. I like your teaching very much and thank you a lot for giving me direction for achieving my goal in JEE Main 2020. Thank you so much, Smile. That's really nice. Thank you. You're just like a god for me once again. Thank you, sir. And always keep smile on your face." Chaliye. Thank you so much, Smile. Please keep following the videos. You'll learn a lot. And if you need any other help regarding your studies, please let me know in the comments. Okay? From Tejas, I get a message. "Sir, binomial theorem is very difficult for me. So please explain shorter ways to crack it for JEE 2021. Sure, Tejas. Actually, binomial theorem is also a part of RMO course. So we will be discussing sequence and series and also binomial theorem in one of the classes of Think Hatke, because that is also a part of Maths Olympiad. So stay tuned, Tejas. I will surely make a video on that and you can watch it and it'll really help you. Okay. Madhav again messaged me, "Sir, I've sent you a question. I solved it by factorization and then made a discriminant greater than A." Yeah, Madhav, that is correct answer. Very nice. You have solved it using a different method, but that is great. Anubhav Kumar says, "Sir, what is the marking scheme of RMO?" So, yaar, RMO is a subjective exam. You will get 6 questions. And I think every question is either of 16 marks or 17 marks. And it is just like how you give exam in your CBSE. So, you have to write every step. You have to think the person who is checking your paper knows nothing. Okay, so you have to write in such a way that the answer should be self-explanatory. Okay, you have to write each line, you don't have to skip steps, because every question is almost equal to 16 or 17 marks. So it's a lot of marks, and if you write it stepwise, you will get more marks rather than a student who knows the answer and does not write things in step. Okay. Ankit Thakur says, "Very nice." Thank you so much, Ankit Thakur. Anubhav Kumar says, "What would be the cutoff for RMO for class 8 for North Bihar?" Anubhav, for class 8, RMO cutoff for North Bihar will not be much. I'm not sure what is the exact number. You can Google for it. You can search past year RMO cutoffs for different states and you will get to know about the North Bihar cutoff. Okay. New Horizon says, "Sir, sorry, aaj main aapka live session attend nahi kar paya. Aapki tarah kismat hai meri." Achha, by the way, I was able to prove the third question using simple algebra and using plus minus. Actually, kal mera phone lock ho gaya tha. Achha. Koi nahi, New Horizons, keep following the videos. Agar aapne miss bhi kar diya, you can watch it again later, but if you're coming, like, that'll be amazing. I get to talk to you one to one. I can get I can interact with you. So if you can come at 7 every day and watch me live, that will be really amazing, so that we can connect with each other and I can help you out in more of the things. Okay, chaliye. So that was all about the comments which were made on Friday's lecture. Now, the previous video, which happened on Saturday, it was a really short video, rather than we didn't discuss much questions. So we'll take out the comments for that video. Mr. Pramod Shambharkar says, "Sir, I'm preparing for JEE. I'm not able to find time to solve your questions because of coaching and study hours. Please also give tips for KVPY essay." Pramod, dekho yaar, I understand. Main pata hai, I've been through that same phase. Main bhi, when I was in 11th and 12th, mereko sabse bada struggle yehi tha ke coaching kaise jaya jaye, and how do you cut, you know, manage time, school ka bhi kaam karna hai, boards ke liye prepare karna hai, and JEE ka bhi kaam karna hai, question khud self study karna hai, coaching bhi attend karna hai. So what you can do is, Pramod, take help from your parents. Tell them that I want to schedule a timetable kind of thing in which I can do almost all of the activities that I want to do in a day. So, like, let's say if I have to do my schoolwork, I have to do my coaching work, I have to solve my self-study questions, and I have to give time for my CBSE board preparation. So, there are four things here that you need to do. So, you have a whole week, plan it out accordingly. You can smartly do the work without, regretting or without, feeling sad about it because you have not done. Agar aap nahi karoge, toh you may feel guilty about it, and that actually hampers your whole preparation. So, usse better aap kya kariye, make a timetable, try to follow that timetable, get up early, sleep late, or sleep whatever works for you. If you want to study raat ko, you can do that. But the productivity, if you talk about productivity increases when you get up in the morning and you study. Raat ko thode lousy ho jate hain log, but like a lot of people used to study raat ko bhi. So whatever works for you, make a timetable, make sure that you know what you need to do and what you actually are missing, like what topics that you have left, or if you had to do this work and let's say something happened and you couldn't do, make sure you do it later. Okay, don't let the whole syllabus, whole every class of coaching or your school compile. Agar ek bar compile karke pahad ban gaya, then it will be really hard for you to manage it. To jitna jaldi aap time management ka use karke solve karenge cheeze, wo utna better hai aapke liye. So please make sure that you are using your whole day properly, and your also whole week help, but take your help from parents. They'll surely help you out. Okay, we have been through that same phase and I understand. So I took help from my parents and they actually told me ke you can find out time here and you can do it. Agar nahi bhi hota hai to dheere dheere ho jayega. So give it a try. Chaliye, next question is by Pranav Singla. कहते हैं, सर, आई एम वीक एट परमिटेशन एंड कॉम्बिनेशन, प्लीज गिव मी सम टिप्स ऑन हाउ टू कवर इट. हाँ प्रणव बच्चा, देखो, हम परमिटेशन कॉम्बिनेशन को वी विल टेक इट एज अ टॉपिक एंड थिंक हटके. जैसे इस वीक का टॉपिक है नंबर थियरी, प्रॉब्ली नेक्स्ट वीक हम वो ले सकते हैं कॉम्बाइनेट्रिक्स, या फिर कुछ और ले सकते हैं, एंड वी विल श्योरली ट्राई टू सॉल्व एज मेनी क्वेश्चन एज वी कैन. विल मेक श्योर दैट वी डिस्कस द थियरीज ऑल्सो. So stay tuned for the video. Otherwise, if you want to study it, you can watch the videos of Neha ma'am. She's also going to put questions and theory on combinatorics pretty soon. So please stay tuned with the video. Shivam Sharma says, amazing. Thank you so much, Shivam. That's great. Anubhav Kumar says, what is RMO marking scheme? Okay. So I think I've already covered it. Okay. PNC, what is RMO? Sir, is series ko baad please theory. So Tech Affairs says, sir, is series ke baad please theory ke saath aap chapters padhana for 9th and 10th also, as because inequality or other topics hum seekhna chah rahe the, but proper theory needed hota hai. Please sir, iske baad, sure, Tech Affair, I'll also include the theory part. Abhi main questions kar raha hu so that the channel can develop. I'm going to make series on the topics that need to study for PRMO, RMO relating to inequalities or number theory. Jo bhi aapke sare topics hain, wo achhe se study karenge ke karke. For now, we are just doing questions so that we can get a base of students. Okay? Chaliye. So, Guys, that is all in today's video. Yeah, so that is all in today's comments. Let's start off with the questions that I gave in the previous class, okay? So it's really nice that you guys are commenting and you're coming up with your problems and, you know, it's really nice and I get to connect with you. If you have any other doubt, kuch bhi if you want, like, sir, ke next week ke liye aap number theory ki jagah hai, kuch aur le sakte. Sorry, this week to number theory hai. Next week, sir, if you can take geometry or combinatrix, you can let me know in the comments which topic you want, okay? Chaliye. So let's start off with the first question. So let's start off with the first question. The first question hamara ye tha that all the seven digits numbers containing each of the digit 1 to 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 hamare paas numbers hain, unse hame ek 7 digit number banana hai. And we can use these digits only once, okay? And not divisible by 5. So we need to find those numbers, 7 digit numbers, which are not divisible by 5, okay? And are arranged in the increasing order. So by increasing order, you mean you start off with 1, then you start off with 2, then you start off with 3. So value of a number, jitna increasing order mein, you start off with a lower value. Okay. So it's more like a dictionary problem. So you have to find the 2000th number in this list. Okay. So hume kya nikalna hai? Hume nikalna hai ki bhai, jo hamara 2000th number hoga, what will that number be? So it's a simple question. Zyada aapko dimag nahi lagana hai. You just think of a 7-digit number. Okay. So isme main kya karunga? Let's say I have my 7 digits. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Theek hai? So I have my 7-digit number here. So basically, what I want to know, first I'll figure out ke yaar, if I take a 1 here. Agar maine yahan pe 1 likha, let's say the first digit of the number is 1. Or uske baad, if I find out how many numbers I can form. So I have a choice of digits from 1 to 7. I've already used 1. So I have 6 digits which I can choose from and I can put it here. So for this place, there are 6 choices. Now if I've used a number, there are 5 numbers left. So this place has 5 choices. Similarly, this has 4, this has 3, this has 2. And this one has 1 only. So what you need to do is you need to multiply all of them. So 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. You can also call it as 6 factorial. And the value of this would be 30, 120, 360, 720. So the value of 6 factorial is 720. So that means you can make 720 numbers starting with 1. And those numbers are 7-digit numbers. But out of those some numbers, there will be few numbers in which the last digit is 5. And if the last digit is 5, then the whole number is divisible by 5. And we do not want that. So what we'll do is we'll try to find out that if the first digit of the number is starting with 1 and the last digit is 5. Last digit I fix at 5. First digit is at 1. I will find out how many 7-digit numbers are there which are divisible by 5. And the numbers are starting with 1. So I have already used 1 and 5. How many numbers are left? Out of 7 numbers, 5 numbers are left. So out of any 5 numbers, I can put any one number here. Okay. Now 4 numbers will be left. I can put any number here. Here only 3 numbers will be left. I can use any one of them and I can put it here. Then I have 2 choices left. I can take any one and put it here. Or last ke liye only 1 choice. So this is nothing but 5 factorial. So if you talk about this, ye kya hai? This is all the 7-digit numbers starting with 7, starting with 1. Now, all the 7-digit numbers, so all the 7-digit numbers, jiska start is at 1 and ending of the number is 5. So, last digit is 5. So, humne kitne number jaise dekhe? 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1, that is 5 factorial, and the value of 5 factorial would be 5, 4s are 20, 23s are 60, 120. So all the 7-digit numbers which start with 1 and end with 5, the total number is 120. So these are all the 7-digit numbers that start with 1. These are all 7-digit numbers which end with 5 and start with 1. So if I subtract both of them, if I subtract 720 and 600, 120, I will get 600, which are the numbers. So I can make 600 numbers with the starting digit as 1, and all these 600 numbers, none of them is divisible by 5, because I eliminated all the numbers which are divisible by 5. So this is pretty simple. So once you observe here, the number of 7-digit numbers with 1 in the left most place and containing each of the digit 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 exactly once is 6 factorial. Maine 1 ko fix kar diya, there are 6 digits left. So 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. So there are 720 numbers, but 120 of these numbers end with 5. So any number which is ending with 5 is divisible by 5. So I'll eliminate those numbers. So I get 600 numbers which are starting with 1 and not divisible by 5. I need to find out the 2000th number. We just have figured out ke pehle 600 number which are not divisible by 5 are what. So basically all those numbers are going to start with 1. Now the next step is, the next step here would be ke yaar agar mere paas mera 7 digit number hai, I started with 1. So as I'm going in increasing order, the next digit I'll use is 2. So my number will start with 2 now. And if you observe all the numbers that I can make here, I have 6 spots and I have 6 choices from which I can use. So total numbers that I can make here is 6 factorial. If I fix a 5, I have 5 numbers left. So 5 choices. So again, I'll get 600. So this basically means I can make 600 numbers again which are starting with 2 and which are not divisible by 5. So I can make 600 of those numbers. So pehle starting with 1 mein 600 the, starting with 2 mein also 600 hai. We will go to the next step. We'll talk about when the numbers are starting with 3. 3 ke liye bhi same cheez hoga. You will get the same calculation. So aapke paas kya jayega? Numbers which are not divisible by 5. Okay, numbers which are not divisible by 5 and starting with 1. Ye kitne numbers ho jayenge? 600. Starting with 2, ye bhi ho jayenge 600 numbers you can make. Starting with 3, again you can make 600 numbers. Okay. Now the next step would be, KR, the next starting number would be 4. So after 1800 numbers, the next number will start off with a 4. Now after 4, the next digit would be the smallest digit you can take. It'll be 1. Okay. And then you can make all the numbers like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. So first you figure out how many digits are left. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 digits are left. There are 5 choices that you can use. So 5 factorial will be the number of numbers that you can make. But out of these numbers, some numbers will be divisible by 5. So what I'll do is I'll fix also a 5 here. And I will see for the rest of the 4 digits, there are 4 choices. So 4 factorial will be the number of numbers which are divisible by 5. So I'll subtract those. And hamare paas kya jayega? 5 factorial is 120. And this is 120 minus 4 factorial. 4 factorial kitna ho jayega? 4 threes are 12. 12 twos are 24. So it'll be 120 minus 24. So that gives you 96. Okay. So there are 96 numbers which are starting with 41 and which are not divisible by 5. So starting with 4, so 41, ye kitne ho jayenge? 96. So if you keep a count of this, 1800 pehle the, ab 1896 numbers ho chuke hain. Okay. So we'll keep doing this. The next digit here would be 42. Hai na? Next digit yahan pe kya hoga? The next digit will be 42. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. यहां पे मैंने अब 1 की जगह 2 आ जाएगा, दैट इज द नेक्स्ट नंबर विच इज बिगर देन 1. 4 2 के बाद क्या करेंगे, अगेन देर आर 5 स्पॉट्स लेफ्ट हियर, 5 चॉइसेस, 5 फैक्टोरियल विल बी द नंबर ऑफ नंबर्स यू कैन मेक. सब्ट्रैक्ट दोज नंबर्स विच आर डिविजिबल बाय 5, आई विल फिक्स 5 हियर, 4 फैक्टोरियल विल बी दोज नंबर्स, आई सब्ट्रैक्ट दैट अगेन, तो मेरे पास क्या आ जाएगा 96. तो नंबर्स विच आर स्टार्टिंग विद 42 एंड नॉट डिविजिबल बाय 5, उसका काउंट भी 96 है. ओके, नाउ आवर प्रोसेस गेट्स मच सिंपलर. हमारे पास कितने नंबर्स आ चुके हैं, जस्ट काउंट कितने नंबर्स है हमारे पास. सो दिस इज 1800 एंड सो 8 शाई ऑफ 2000, तो 1992 नंबर्स हमारे पास ऑलरेडी आ चुके हैं. ओके, 1800 ये हो गए एंड यू सब्ट्रैक्ट 4 फ्रॉम 100 यू गेट 96. तो बेसिकली 2000 में आपको 8 सब्ट्रैक्ट करेंगे, यू विल गेट 1992 नंबर्स, वो हमारे काउंट में आ गए हैं. व्हाट विल बी द नेक्स्ट नंबर, व्हाट विल बी द नेक्स्ट नंबर, हमने स्टार्ट किया था 42 से, अगला होगा 43, देन द स्मॉलेस्ट डिजिट 1, फिर 2, फिर 3, 1 2 3 4 5, 5 4. ओके, सिंस आई एम फाइंडिंग आउट द नंबर्स विच आर नॉट डिविजिबल बाय 5, I cannot take 4, 5 because it will end in a 5. So this number will be the 1992nd number. Okay. Iske agla number kya hoga? The next number will be, you can replace these two. So it will be 4, 3, 1, 2, 5, 3, 4. Okay. So this will be the next number in line. So like this, I'll keep writing down the numbers. Agar aap yahan pe observe karenge, तो हा सो 1993 वाला जो नंबर होगा इट विल बी दिस नंबर. 4 3 से स्टार्ट किया, फिर 1 2 3 ऑलरेडी हो चुका है, 4 5 6 7, 4 भी ऑलरेडी यूज हो सकता है, आई कैन यूज 5 6 7. तो 5 6 7 नेक्स्ट नंबर होगा, फिर उसके बाद 6 और 7 को चेंज कर देंगे बिकॉज दैट इज अ बिगर नंबर, तो नेक्स्ट विल बी 76. उसके बाद क्या करेंगे, आई हैड अ 5 हेयर 100th प्लेस पे, 1000th प्लेस पे, तो यहां पे क्या आ जाएगा, यू विल गेट अ 6, और 6 अगर यहां पे आ गया यू कैन टेक अ 5 हेयर एंड 7 हेयर. तो ऐसे करते करते यू विल कीप फॉर्मिंग न्यू नंबर्स इन अ इंक्रीजिंग ऑर्डर एंड यू विल रीच दिस नंबर विच इज द 2000th नंबर. So 4 3 1 5 6 7 2 would be the 2000th number, or that will be your answer. Okay, so it's a classic question of a little bit of number theory, a little bit of combinatrix. You will also study these questions in 11th class chapter permutation and combination. Aise type ke questions kafi aate hain wahan pe, even in boards they come a lot. So this is a simple question, a classic question. Okay, chaliye let's go to the next question. So this was the second question that I asked. Find all primes P and Q such that P square plus 7PQ plus Q square is a perfect square. तो यार जहां पे भी perfect square का बात आता है, everywhere there is a talk of perfect square, I will put that expression equal to square of something. Okay? तो मैंने exactly यही चीज किया. If you notice here, P and Q are primes. तो मुझे बोला गया P and Q are primes. तो what I'll do is I'll say कि भाई ये is equal to some square. तो m स्क्वायर मैंने बोल दिया, ठीक है, फॉर सम पॉजिटिव इंटीजर m. अब क्या करेंगे हम, वी कैन मॉडिफाई दिस इक्वेशन इनटू दिस, 5pq इज इक्वल टू m स्क्वायर माइनस p प्लस q का होल स्क्वायर, व्हिच वी कैन फैक्टराइज इनटू m प्लस p प्लस q इनटू m माइनस p माइनस q. ठीक है, तो बेसिकली हमारे पास क्या एक्सप्रेशन आ गया, m प्लस p प्लस q इनटू m माइनस p माइनस q इक्वल टू 5pq. प्रोडक्ट ऑफ दीज टू थिंग्स इज इक्वल टू 5pq. अब आपको यहां पर नोटिस करने वाली बात क्या है कि यार प्रोडक्ट ऑफ टू थिंग्स इज इक्वल टू 5pq. तो 5 की pq आर 3 नंबर्स विच आर मल्टीप्लाइड, p एंड q आर ऑल्सो प्राइम्स. तो वी कैन फिगर आउट कि भाई ये वैल्यू क्या होगी, ये वैल्यू क्या होगी. नाउ m प्लस p प्लस q कुड बी एनीथिंग, इट कुड बी 5, इट कुड बी p, इट कुड बी pq, इट कुड बी q, इट कुड बी 5pq. सो लेट्स सी व्हाट इट कैन बी. तो हम क्या करेंगे, हम देखते हैं यार कि p स्क्वायर प्लस 7q स्क्वायर एंड q स्क्वायर, दिस होल एक्सप्रेशन इज इक्वल टू m स्क्वायर. तो इसका मतलब क्या हुआ, कैन आई से दैट m इज गोइंग टू बी ग्रेटर देन p, ऑब्वियसली. and obviously it is going to be greater than Q. And P and Q are prime numbers, so unka minimum value to 2 hoga hi. Hai na? To unko add karenge aur M is also greater than P and Q. To M and P, M, P aur Q ka jo sum hoga, that will be more than 5. So that is why this is not possible. M plus P plus Q is cannot be equal to P. M plus P plus Q cannot be equal to Q. And M plus P plus Q cannot be equal to 5. So aapko ye teen cheez note karne wali yahan pe ye hai. यार इनकी वैल्यू p q और 5 नहीं हो सकती. ठीक है, तो ये जो ना हमारे पास जो प्रोडक्ट्स हैं ये क्या क्या हो सकते हैं, फिर पॉसिबिलिटी क्या बची. दिस कुड बी 5q, दिस कुड बी 5p. ओके, और क्या पॉसिबिलिटी है, दिस कुड आल्सो बी 5pq. ओके, ये तीन पॉसिबिलिटीज हैं हमारे पास. तो चलिए लेट्स स्टार्ट ऑफ विद इट. तो सबसे पहला पॉसिबिलिटी मैं क्या लूंगा, लेट्स से ये जो सम है, दिस सम इज इक्वल टू 5. या आई विल अज्यूम द सम टू बी इक्वल टू 5p. ओके, तो अगर ये 5p है तो ये जो सेकंड प्रोडक्ट है दैट विल बी इक्वल टू q. तो ये मैंने बोल दिया q के इक्वल है. व्हाट आई विल डू इज आई विल सबट्रैक्ट बोथ द इक्वेशंस, m विल एलिमिनेट एंड आई विल गेट 2 टाइम्स p प्लस q इज इक्वल टू 5p माइनस q. और अगर आप इस इक्वेशन को सॉल्व करते हैं यू विल गेट p इज इक्वल टू q. ठीक है, तो अगर आपके पास ये रिजल्ट आता है कि भाई m प्लस p प्लस q इज इक्वल टू 5p और इसको आप अगर q मानते हैं, आपके पास रिजल्ट आएगा कि भाई बोथ द प्राइम नंबर्स आर सेम. ओके, तो एक रिजल्ट हमारे पास क्या आ गया कि अगर दोनों प्राइम नंबर्स p एंड q आर सेम यू विल ऑलवेज गेट अ परफेक्ट स्क्वायर. लेट्स चेक. सो लेट्स से p इज 2 एंड q इज ऑल्सो 2, तो ये हो जाएगा 4 प्लस 2 इंटू 2, 4, 4, 7 इज 28, प्लस 4, तो ये कितना आ रहा है 36, विच इज अ परफेक्ट स्क्वायर. तो ऑल द प्राइम नंबर्स इफ पी एंड क्यू आर इक्वल, तो यहां पे मैं सॉल्यूशन लिख देता हूं कि इफ पी एंड क्यू आर इक्वल एंड पी इज नथिंग बट अ प्राइम नंबर. ओके, उस केस में यू विल ऑलवेज फाइंड दिस एक्सप्रेशन एज अ परफेक्ट स्क्वायर. ठीक है, अगला क्या सिचुएशन आएगा, I took the case this to be 5p. अगर ये 5q होगा तो क्या होगा, If I take this sum as 5q, so ये हो जाएगा p. When I take a difference of both the equations, again I get p is equal to q. तो again वो भी हमारा result दोबारा valid हो गया. तो अगर दो primes equal हैं, p और q equal हैं और यहां पे डालेंगे, it will solve. Okay? Last क्या बचेगा, last क्या है, m प्लस p प्लस q, इफ आई टेक इट एज pq, ओके, अगर मैंने इसको लिया pq और इसको लिया मैंने एज 5, दोनों इक्वेशंस को सब्ट्रैक्ट करेंगे यू विल गेट 2 टाइम्स p प्लस q इज इक्वल टू pq माइनस 5. अगर आप इस इक्वेशन को फैक्टराइज करेंगे यू विल गेट दिस एक्सप्रेशन, p माइनस 2 इंटू q माइनस 2 इज इक्वल टू 9. है ना, तो यार 9 को आप क्या लिख सकते हो, यू कैन राइट 9 एज 9 इंटू 1 और 3 इंटू 3. है ना, तो अगर इसको मैं 3 इंटू 3 लिखता हूं you will get the value of the expression as p minus 2 is equal to 3 and q minus 2 is also equal to 3. तो दोनों का value 5 आ जाएगा. वो यहां पे already true हो रहा है क्योंकि you can take 5 as a prime number और अगर दोनों primes को same रखेंगे 5 तो you'll get a solution. कोई और solution आ रहा है, let's check. अगर मैंने 9 into 1 लिया, if I take it as 9 into 1 तो p माइनस 2 इज इक्वल टू 9, तो p का वैल्यू आ जाएगा 11, q का वैल्यू आ जाएगा 3. सिमिलरली इफ आई टेक p माइनस 2 टू बी 1, p का वैल्यू 3 आ जाएगा और q का वैल्यू 11. तो हमारे पास बेसिकली क्या सॉल्यूशन आ गए, एक आ गया 3 11, नेक्स्ट इज 11 3 एंड नेक्स्ट इज बोथ द नंबर्स आर सेम एंड दे आर प्राइम नंबर्स. ओके, सो दिस इज द सॉल्यूशन ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन. आई होप यू गाइस अंडरस्टूड इट. ठीक है, आसान था क्वेश्चन, ध्यान से देखिए, विल बी एबल टू सॉल्व इट आफ्टर यू study the solution once. Okay, now the next question was a bonus question. Ye thoda out of the box question hota hai that you have to think about ke isme kuch tigram lagta hai, something unique. So the question was, a teacher drew several circles on a sheet of paper, then he asked a student how many circles are there. 7 was the answer. Correct, said the teacher. So how many circles are there, the teacher asked another student. 5. So, दूसरे बच्चे ने 5 बोला, एक और बच्चे ने 7 बोला. एब्सोल्यूटली राइट. तो टीचर ने बोला दोनों को दैट यू बोथ आर करेक्ट. तो हाउ मेनी सर्कल्स आर एक्चुअली देयर ऑन अ शीट. तो यार कंफ्यूजिंग तो है. एक शीट ऑफ पेपर पे बच्चे से पूछा कि भाई कितने सर्कल्स है, उसने बोला 7. दे आस्क अनदर स्टूडेंट कितने सर्कल्स है, उसने बोला 5. तो बेसिकली, और टीचर ने बोला कि भाई तुम दोनों सही हो, बोथ ऑफ यू आर राइट. हाउ इज दैट पॉसिबल? व्हाट आर द एक्चुअल नंबर ऑफ सर्कल्स? तो यार इस क्वेश्चन का एक सिंपल सा आंसर है, देर आर 12 सर्कल्स. ओके, 5 ऑफ देम आर ऑन द वन साइड ऑफ द शीट एंड 7 ऑफ देम आर ऑन द अदर साइड ऑफ द शीट. मतलब यार जब इस बच्चे को दिखाया शीट तो देर वर 7 सर्कल्स, देन शी फ्लिप्ड द शीट एंड शोड इट टू समवन एल्स एंड ही सेड 5 सर्कल्स. सो दैट इज द ओनली पॉसिबल वे इन विच दिस कुड हैपन, अदरवाइज कोई और पॉसिबिलिटी नहीं है. ठीक है, थोड़ा सा ट्रिक क्वेश्चन था, दिस वॉज अ गिमिक क्वेश्चन. होप यू गाइज एंजॉयड इट. चलिए, सो नाउ आई विल बी गिविंग यू क्वेश्चंस ऑफ नंबर थियरी फॉर कल का वीडियो. फॉर टुमारोज वीडियो आई हैव गॉट सम प्रीटी गुड क्वेश्चंस. तो आपका पहला क्वेश्चन है ये, इफ ए बी एंड सी आर 3 रियल नंबर्स सच दैट ए माइनस बी इज ग्रेटर देन और इक्वल टू सी, दिस एंड दिस इज ग्रेटर देन और इक्वल टू बी, प्रूव दैट वन ऑफ ए बी सी इज द सम ऑफ द अदर टू. ये आपको बताना है. ठीक है, तो ये आपका पहला क्वेश्चन है. द सेकेंड क्वेश्चन इज दिस, फाइंड द लीस्ट पॉसिबल वैल्यू ऑफ ए प्लस बी वेयर ए एंड बी आर पॉजिटिव इंटीजर्स एंड 11 डिवाइड्स ए प्लस 13 बी एंड 13 डिवाइड्स ए प्लस 11 बी. ठीक है, तो ये एक और नंबर थ्योरी का क्वेश्चन डिविजिबिलिटी पे. एंड द लास्ट क्वेश्चन है, सो द लास्ट क्वेश्चन है इज दिस, आपके पास दिस इज अ आउट ऑफ द बॉक्स क्वेश्चन, दिस इज अ बोनस क्वेश्चन. देर आर 3 टर्टल्स विच आर क्रॉलिंग अलॉन्ग अ स्ट्रेट लाइन हेडिंग इन द सेम डायरेक्शन. 2 अदर टर्टल्स आर बिहाइंड मी सेज द फर्स्ट टर्टल. 1 टर्टल इज बिहाइंड मी एंड 1 इज अहेड ऑफ मी सेज द सेकेंड. 2 टर्टल्स आर अहेड ऑफ मी एंड 1 अदर इज बिहाइंड मी सेज द थर्ड टर्टल. हाउ कैन दिस बी पॉसिबल? तो यार इसके ऊपर थोड़ा सोचिए, विल डिस्कस इट इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास. तो आज का वीडियो बस इतना ही है. प्लीज मेक श्योर दैट यू डू द नंबर थ्योरी क्वेश्चंस. कल की क्लास में विल डिस्कस मोर. एंड दैट इज ऑल फॉर टुडेज वीडियो गाइस. होप यू एंजॉयड इट और विल मीट इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो. सो प्लीज स्टे ट्यून्ड. प्लीज लेट मी नो इन द कमेंट्स व्हाट आर द आंसर्स टू द क्वेश्चन एंड विल प्रोसीड इट फ्रॉम द नेक्स्ट क्लास ऑनवर्ड्स. ओके, थैंक यू सो मच फॉर लिसनिंग मी. बहुत अच्छा लगा. यू गाइज वर हेयर. I'll see you guys in the next video. Stay tuned, keep learning. Good night, take care, bye.